děli. Já si totiž myslím, že jako občanům, normálním občanům je úplně jedno, jako kdo je akcionářem jaké společnosti. Oni řeší, kolik zaplatí v tom inkasu nebo na té složence. Pane Kubine, vy se pletete, pardon, že vám do tu skáču, to je tím, že to máte někým napsáno. Prostě Brno je stejný model jako v Ostravě, naprosto stejný. Já z hlediska vlastnictví, ta hlediska ztrát vody. Já děkuju, já moc nevím, na co mám jako reagovat, jako vy se sám usvědčujete, promiňte, z neznalosti, jo, nebo z toho, že vám špatně zpracovávají podklady. Znova říkám, Brno je úplně stejný model jako v Ostravě, to znamená, no dobře, ale je to dost podstatná věc, já vím, že vy rád jako fabulujete, ale je dobře, aby to tady zaznělo. I proto Brno a Ostrava, nejnižší ztráty vody v České republice, nejnižší cena vody v České republice.
Jenom tak, protože se mi to zatím nepodařilo dohledat nikde a vím, že se k tomu vyjadřoval pan náměstek Svozil a vy to určitě taky budete vědět, když se tím tak podrobně zabýváte, pane primátore. Netušíte, za kolik vlastně ten Suez tenkrát pořídil ty akcie v OVAKu, jenom jestli víte, kdybyste mi odpověděli, protože se mi nepodařilo dosud dohledat na ten údaj. Děkuji.
To vám opravdu neřeknu, nevím to, určitě se to dá dohledat, neznám a nechci to teď, jako nechci tady házet nějaké hypotetické sumy. A nelze hypoteticky zpětně nějak vyvozovat nějaké číslo, ani nevím, čemu by nám bylo v situaci, kdy se rozhodujeme o budoucnosti, ne o minulosti. Domníváme se v tom novém programovém období na dotace dosáhnout, v jaké výši je rizí spekulace, protože ty programy nikdo v dané chvíli nezná, stejně jako nezná programy v žádné jiné oblasti. Argumentovat tou ekonomikou v daném případě prostě neobstojí. Zisk ani dividenda není sprosté slovo, je to prostě odměna za podnikání. Ten provozovatel nese nemalá provozní rizika a ten zisk není výsledkem toho, že město investuje. A není pravdou to, co říkáte vy, pane Kubíne, že automaticky s pokrokem vodárenství jdou všude ztráty dolů. Není to tak prostě, na tom se projevuje činnost té provozní společnosti, technologie, se kterou přichází iSpeaking, kterou OVAK například realizuje jako první a jediná společnost v rámci České republiky. Další věci, já jsem v jejich datacentrech v Paříži, v laboratořích, tam vidíte věci jako prostě z kosmického výzkumu, když to přeženu, takže není to tak, že to je prostě automatické a že to má každá vodárna v této republice.
Grenoble, a city in the French Alps. Here the other global player, Suez Lyonnais Dassault, has shown how the competence and experience of a private company are to be combined with the interests of the mayor.
For 100 years, the water was under public administration, which functioned really well. As I was elected into the city council of Grenoble in 1989, the pipes, canalization, water reservoirs and the water pump system were in good condition. The mayor at the time, who was the former environmental minister, decided however to privatize in 1989 and passed on the complete management of water to Lyonnais Dassault Suez. Here is where Suez bribed the mayor. And it's here where the decision was made to privatize the water in Grenoble. This is also the place where the corrupt mayor was sentenced for privatizing the water to Lyonnaise des Eaux's advantage.
Au bénéfice de la Lyonnaise des Eaux.
The bribe sum of 2 million euros was paid to him in the form of trips, cruises, apartments, and by financing his election campaign.
Au maire de Grenoble, les très hauts responsables.
The three people from Suez mainly responsible were also sentenced with corruption. But the moral person, the company itself, was not sentenced.
Pas été condamné pour corruption.
The chief executive at the time was Jérôme Monod, who later became the first advisor to the President of the Republic of France, Jacques Chirac. The mayor was Alain Carignan. He was sentenced to several years in prison. As we wrote the book, he was still Minister of Communication. That made our job difficult. When the book came on the market, he was already in jail. Throughout the whole time, he remained close to Sarkozy. He's seen on photos next to Mr. Sarkozy during the election campaign.
Récente campagne électorale avec la photo de Monsieur Sarkozy à côté.
You see that on this montage here as well. Together, all is possible. And he remains a close friend to the highest person in the French state.
À Grenoble, nous avons aujourd'hui.
We call it the lesson from Grenoble. Our water supply was in private hands for 10 years. Now it's been handled by the community again since 10 years. So we can compare.
Aujourd'hui, 10 ans de remunicipalisation du service des eaux. Donc nous pouvons.
What happened during the time of privatization? Lyonnaise des Eaux confiscated the complete knowledge. They even printed their stamp on all the pipeline maps. They made the know-how and the heritage their own.
C'est approprié.
At that time, there were no one left within the public service with enough knowledge and who could control them.
Pour connaître, contrôler, savoir. Et là,
the corporation raised the water prices and reduced pipeline maintenance and renovations to draw higher profits.
Ce qui lui a permis de faire plus de profit. Ça, c'est le prix de.
This is the water price at the time of privatization. Privatization at Suez. The price goes up. We take it back into our hands. And here we see how the price has developed. At the same time, we've tripled the maintenance work, the renovations of the canal network and installations.
The South French Montpellier.
I find the management of water in Montpellier disgusting. There have been cases of corruption and of people taking advantage of the situation. The city council granted Veolia, formerly Compagnie Générale des Eaux, an operating leasing agreement in 1989. In 1994, a congressional investigation committee was established, which then sentenced Compagnie Générale des Eaux for corruption and for bribery. The Compagnie paid 8 million francs to a department within reign of the Communist Party to force them to vote for the operating lease agreement, which they did. The briber was sentenced, those who bribed were not.
Mais les corrompus n'ont pas été condamnés, ni même embêtés. Voilà, voilà.
Despite the conviction of those responsible at the time from Veolia in Montpellier, Jean-Dominique Sochon, the management of water is still in the hands of the corporation.
Jezdíte do té Francie se koukat, jak to tam teda dělají, abyste se poučil. Takže tolik asi, no. Děkuju.
Já vím, že vy jste jako máte ve zvyku tyto podpásové jaksi reakce. Nejezdím se do Francie koukat, já na to nemám čas, byl jsem tam jednou za těch 7 let, jednou na 1,5 dne. Jo, všechno zisky škaredým kapitalistům odchází. Český národ pláče. Já jsem především předkladatel materiálu, pane kolego. Jo, proto ho tady obhajuji. Já jsem předkladatel, takže z toho si prosím vyvozte moji citovou angažovanost.
Complete overlapping of roles. And when politicians lose an election, they get hired by Suez or Veolia.
They hire people with the power to influence the commissioning of official public assignment contracts or influence those members of Congress who create the laws. For example, deciding on alteration requests, ultimately allowing them access to construction assignment contracts, such as the adaptation of the canal system to newer standards, things that are immediately beneficial to them. They are creating supply and demand themselves with the help of government officials and their lobbyists.
Brussels, the European Union Parliament, and the attempt to unravel the widely ramified network through which Veolia is affecting the European Union.
The lobbying of Veolia Environnement Brussels in water, basically you can say it is important to have a very, very wide and diversified lobbying network to be efficient. What is important is to have the same kind of message delivered through as many channels as possible. So you can use think tanks to organize debates. You can use general business lobbies. You can use specialized water lobbies, such as those ones. And you can use global bodies, such as the World Water Forum, etc. For example, Veolia is dominating one body which is very closely advising DG Research about what kind of projects, research projects, it should fund in the five coming years. They are the main funders, I think they are the biggest funders, of an entity which is called the Water Supply and Sanitation Technology Platform. So this means basically Veolia is influencing the Commission on research projects it will apply to afterwards. So basically it will get the European Commission funding project it has asked to be funded.
The privatization waves in Europe were never brought on by a large public discourse, but always by a sudden court decision made by the European Supreme Court of Justice, with the intention to force entry into one market or other, or a guideline by the European Commission. And that's why I say, be awake is the rule of thumb. The corporations who wish to break into these business areas continue to exist, and they are constantly rattling the gate of entry to these markets.
The speaker for the European Union Commission opens the declaration on the 19th of May 2009. Water is a commodity like everything else. Thereby, the intention of the European Union Commission was affirmed to open up the market for private firms by obligating the public utilities to request proposals.
The system today is a true financial dictatorship, and the water is held hostage by this financial dictatorship.
qu'on corrompt, qu'on donne à un système quelque forme de...
If you meddle in this corrupt system, or give grants, credits, or gifts, then you have to very generously spread your money. Even environmental organizations, even those I really value, such as French Nature Environment, are being generously financed by Veolia Propreté, or Actions Against Hunger, the Red Cross, La Solidarité, and others. Even in the Catholic aid organization Secours Catholique, the one responsible for issues regarding water is a former chief of staff at Veolia. On every level, we're up against a